Hello and welcome to the maths class. Let's continue our section on circles, intersection of chords, standard 10, chapter 2. Our next discussion is on converting a rectangle into a square of the same area. Let us think about our second result about the intersecting chords. Suppose one of the chords is a diameter and the second chord is perpendicular to it, we had the result that PA into PB equals PC squared. We had changed this into a simpler form. We need not draw the full circle. We need only to draw the semicircle with the diameter. So the diameter is AB. And we need to draw only half of the perpendicular chord, which is PC. So from this figure, we can again say PA multiplied by PB equals PC square. That is our second result in intersecting chords. Now we had already seen that PA multiplied by PB also means that it is the area of a rectangle with sides PA and PB. So what does PA multiplied by PB equals PC squared mean? What is the meaning of PC squared? PC squared can also be represented as PC multiplied by PC. Isn't that equal to the area of a square with side PC? Yes, geometrically, PC squared is the area of a square with side PC. So let's see what we have just found out. PA into PB is the area of a rectangle with sides PA and PB. PC squared is the area of a square with side PC. Thus, PA multiplied by PB equal to PC squared also means the area of a rectangle with sides PA and PB is equal to the area of a square with sides PC. In other words, we can use this to convert a rectangle into a square of the same area. Let us try to make such a construction. I have a rectangle here with sides 6 centimeters and 3 centimeters. Its area is 18 centimeters squared. I want to change it into a square, but without change in area. The area should be 18 centimeters squared. Here we can use our idea of intersecting chords. The second rule, which says PA into PB equals PC squared, where PA and PB are two parts of the diameter and PC is half of the chord perpendicular to it. So first, we are going to draw the first chord, our diametrical chord, with 6 centimeters and 3 centimeters. So 6 centimeters and 3 centimeters. So I have the points A and B on the two ends of the diameter and P is the point of intersection. So I write P here. Now we need our semicircle. How do we draw the semicircle? The total length of the diameter is 9 centimeters. We need the midpoint of 9 centimeters to draw the semicircle. That will be at 4.5. So I mark a point at the 4.5 centimeters and using compass, I complete the semicircle. Now I have my diametrical chord and the semicircle. All we need now is the perpendicular half of the perpendicular chord at the point P using a protractor or a set square. We can draw the perpendicular from P to the circle. Mark the point as C. We have got our required perpendicular, half of the required perpendicular chord. According to our result of intersecting chords, in this case also PA multiplied by PB equals PC squared. 6 multiplied by 3 equals PC squared. 6 and 3 are parts of the rectangle. PC squared or PC is the side of the square that we need. If I need to complete the square, I need to mark all the four parts as PC. So I already have a PC, taking that length with a compass. I can construct arcs, draw arcs and complete my square. I have the square with the side as PC. Now let's see our rectangle and our square. Our rectangle is with 6 centimeters and 3 centimeters. And our square has area PC squared. The area of this rectangle is 6 into 3, 18. We have PA into PB equals PC squared. So the area of the square is also 18. This is our required square. Let's also find out the length of PC. PA into PB equals 6 into 3 equals 18. PC squared is equal to 18. So PC is equal to root of 18. So the side of the square is root of 18 centimeters.